For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report from your Sample Files folder. Make sure that you open the Session 7 Sales Report file, as there's also a sample file of the same name in an earlier session. I'm going to begin this lesson by print previewing the worksheet to see how it would look on paper. To do that, I click File at the top left of the screen, and then Print on the left-hand menu bar. Notice that I have A4 paper loaded in my printer. But if you're in North America or Canada, you may have letter-size paper loaded into your printer. The sample files in this session have been set up to use A4 paper. You'll still be able to complete all the lessons in this session if you're using letter-size paper, but you might find that screen grabs and any hard copy printed is slightly different to that shown in this video. International differences in paper sizes will be discussed in depth in Lesson 7.4. Now let's look at the print preview itself. On the right-hand side of the screen, you can see a preview of exactly how this worksheet will look when printed onto paper. And notice that at the bottom right of the screen, there's a Zoom to Page button. If I click the Zoom to Page button, you'll see that the preview expands in size so that you can see its contents more clearly. I'll now click the Zoom to Page button again so that I can once again see the whole sheet of paper. Notice that to the bottom left of the print preview, there's a Previous Page and Next Page button. And I can also see that I'm currently looking at the first page of what will be a 10-page printout. If I click the Next Page button, I'll move forwards through each of the pages in the printout. But when I reach page 6, notice that a problem is revealed, because the paper isn't wide enough to show all of the columns on the worksheet. Excel tries to help out by printing the leftmost columns across the first 5 pages, followed by the rightmost columns on the next 5 pages. You'd have to take the 2 pages, cut them with scissors, and tape them together in order to see all of the rows and columns. And obviously, that wouldn't be a very good solution. So let's see if we can solve this problem by changing the orientation of the paper. You can see that at the moment I have portrait orientation. But if I click on portrait orientation, you can see there's a landscape orientation option. I'll click landscape orientation now, and you can see that in landscape orientation, the paper is printed as if it had been put into the printer sideways. If I move down the printout to page 9, I can see that I still haven't solved the problem. The printout's very nearly there, but the last column is still printing out on a page of its own. Now, I could solve this problem in 2 ways. The first thing I could do would be to scale the printout so that all of the letters and numbers were shown in a slightly smaller font. And we'll explore this solution in Lesson 7.4. The second solution might be to change the width of the margins on the printout. That's the white space to the left and right of the printed page. And we'll explore this solution in Lesson 7.2. I'm now going to click the Back button to return to the Excel screen. And notice that when we want to produce a print preview of a worksheet, it takes 2 mouse clicks. I need to first click on the File tab of the ribbon, and then I need to click Print in the left-hand menu bar. Now I'm going to show you a way in which you can do this with just 1 click of the mouse, because you'll use the print preview feature a lot. I'll click the Back button at the top of the menu bar, and I'm going to use the skills you learned in Lesson 1.14 to add a print preview button to the Quick Access Toolbar. So I'll click the drop-down arrow to the right of the Quick Access Toolbar, and I'll select Print Preview and Print. And when I click, you can see that a new icon is added to the Quick Access Toolbar, the Print Preview and Print icon. I'm now going to click this icon once, and with 1 click, you've moved directly to the print preview. And if I did want to print this worksheet to paper, I could now click the print button and that would happen. But I won't do that now because I want to save 16 sheets of paper. I'll click the back button to return to Excel, and all that remains for this lesson is to save your work. And I'm going to save with the new name, Sales Report 1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I'll click the Save button, and you'll probably see a dialog saying that Sales Report 1 already exists. That's because we used this same name in an earlier session. So I'll click Yes to overwrite it. And you've now completed Lesson 7.1, Print Preview and Change Paper Orientation.